Hello and welcome to our channel Make Explained. I am Abhijit and today I will do some more numericals on gate questions. This is the part 2 of gate level questions by using Bernoulli's equation. So have patience and stay till the end and watch the video and learn the concept very well. A liquid flows downward through a tapered vertical portion of a pipe. At the entrance and exit of the pipe, the static pressure are equal. That means one. The liquid flows downward through a taper vertical portion of a pipe. Okay. At entrance and exit of the pipe, the static pressure are equal. That means pressure at P1 and P2 are equals. If for a vertical height h, that means height is h, height, or we you can say z1 minus z2, this is for height, velocity becomes 4 times. That means if v1 equals to v, v2 will be 4v, okay, velocity becomes 4 times. Then the ratio of h to the velocity head, ratio of what? Ratio of h and to the velocity head. What is velocity head? V square by 2g. Right, so ratio of h by v square by 2g they are asking. Okay, so we can use Bernoulli's equation, p1 by rho g plus v1 square by 2g plus z1 equals to p2 by rho g plus v2 square by 2g plus z2. So p1 and p2 is same. Okay, so this both side cancel out, so and v1 square by 2g, that means z1 is equals to h, v2 square by 2g, z2 equals to 0, that means z1 minus z2 equals to h. So v1 equals to v square by 2g and plus h equals to v2 means 4v, right, 4v by 2g whole square, that means h equals to 16v square minus v square 2g, that means v square, if we take common v square by 2g, then 16 minus 1 equals to 15, right? That means h by v square by 2g, h by v square by 2g equals to 15. And so this is the correct answer, right? 15. This is our second question, the question number 75. In the question, they are telling, consider steady, incompressible and irrotational flow through a reducer in a horizontal pipe where the diameter is reduced from 20 cm to 10 cm. That means the pipe is reducing from 20 cm to 10 cm. This will look like this, 20 cm. To 10 centimeter. Okay, the pressure in the 20 centimeter pipe just upstream of the pressure upstream of the reducer is 150 kPa. That means before 20 centimeter the pressure is just 150 kPa. That means here, if this is 1 and 2 section, then that means here the pressure what comes is 150 kPa. That means P1 equals to 150 kPa. And the fluid has a vapor pressure of 50 kPa. Acha, vapor pressure. They are saying vapor pressure is 50 kPa. Right. This is something new. This is something new term, right? Vapor pressure and specific weight of 5 kN per meter cube. Specific weight is 5 kN per meter cube, right? This is also something new term we are hearing. So what is specific weight, we will discuss later. So neglecting frictional effects, the maximum discharge that can pass through the reducer without causing cavitation. The maximum discharge, that means rate of flow, maximum rate of flow Q max, right? They are asking Q max, P1 by rho G, P1 square by 2G plus Z1 equals to P2 by rho G plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. Okay, so at here we don't know V1 and V2, and we don't know Q equal also. We know, so we know Q equals to A1 V1, right? But we know, don't know Q1, so we cannot calculate the V velocity at right at here, right? So what can we do? We can use the continuity equation. A1 V1 equals to A2 V2, right? A1 is pi by 4 D1 square. D1 is 20 centimeter, that means 0.2 meter. That means 0.5 by 4 into 0.2 the whole square into V1 equals to pi by 4 into 0.1 whole square into V2, right? Pi by 4 cancel out. 0.04 equals V1 equals to 0.01 V2. Okay. By 100 by 100 equals to 4 V1 equals to V2. That means V2 equals to 4 V1. Okay. Now, we know pressure at inlet is 150 kPa. Z1 and Z2 are similar. Z1 equals to Z2 similar because the datum line is going from going like this. So Z1 and Z2 is similar. Okay, if it is, this is datum, then Z1, Z2 and Z1 will be same. Okay, we have to know what is P2, right? Through the reducer without causing cavitation, what will be the maximum rate of flow through the reducer without causing cavitation? For not having cavitation, the pressure should be atmospheric pressure. In the hydraulic playlist you will find, while watching the turbine videos, we will know about cavitation. The cavitation is due to the pressure difference. Okay, the pressure difference between the atmospheric pressure and the outlet pressure. Okay, if the atmospheric pressure at here and outlet pressure is different, then it will be, there will be a cavitation. Okay, if we want that there is no cavitation, then we have to take the P2 as vapor pressure. Okay, so this new term will be used as like this. Like P2 will be 50 kPa. Okay, so for not having cavitation, the P2 should be vapor pressure. And specific weight, what is specific weight? Specific weight is the multiplication of density with gravitational force. Okay, rho g, rho g will be specific gravity. So rho g equals to 5 kN per meter cube. Now you can put P1 equals to 150, rho g equals to 5, V1 square equals to V square by 2g plus Z1 and Z2 is 0, P2 equals to 50 by 5 plus V2 equals to 4 V1 whole square by 2g plus Z2 equals to 0. So V, after calculating, V1 is 5.114 meter per second. So Q max will be A1 V1. Okay, at here the Q is maximum because the diameter is more, so that from here means rate of flow, that means Q will be maximum. So Q max will be area, that means pi by 4 D equals to 0.2 whole square into V1 equals to 5.114 equals to 0.161 meter cube per second. So this is the answer. In this question we know that for not having cavitation, this have to be a vapor pressure. Okay, and specific gravity is rho into g. If you like the video, then please subscribe to our channel. In the next lecture we will be doing the applications of Bernoulli's equation.